صحبات Moses, all these lights was off, all switched off, finished, and now only Allah Almighty is going to everyone who obey Him. Allah Almighty will mercy him. The one who will not obey, no one of the awliya can interfere between him and Allah Almighty. Allah now, He wants to teach people how to respect Allah Almighty, how to respect Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how to respect each other, how to be in the way of Allah Almighty and not to be in the way of shaitan. And for this it is very difficult. Problem, how much awliya will talk, how much Mawlana talk, how much everyone is saying, telling, advising, no one listening. No one that cares. Everyone now is so busy himself by everything which make Allah Almighty unhappy. And if you tell the one to do by what Allah is happy, he ignore it as if he is not listening to what you are saying. Keep this for yourself. All people happy with shaitan. No one is happy with Allah Almighty. Instead to be happy with Allah Almighty, with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with awliya, they are happy with shaitan. السورة سيدنا شيخ أسماء ولي الله قد يسعد الحمد لله you have in your country here plenty of أولياء especially big مقام سيدنا شيخ أسماء who tolerate even tolerating but still it is very heavy descending how much they are tolerating And for this Mawlana say the best thing in these days and also in months of Rajab, Sha'ban and Ramadan, always the best thing is to carry your tasbih and to say Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. No other any practicing will be benefit for the one of us except Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. As Allah Almighty promising Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will not punish them. You are in between them. When you are in between them, never punishment will come over your ummah, your nation. And then Rasulullah, when I will pass away, what will happen? He told also Allah Almighty then descending Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam to make Rasulullah happy. وما كان الله ليعذبهم وانت فيهم وما كان الله ليعذبهم وهم يستغفرون. If they keep repenting to Allah Almighty and saying Astaghfirullah all the time, these ones whom they are saying Astaghfirullah never receive punishment from Allah Almighty. Only Allah will bless them to be well rewarded and to be always upgraded and to be always under the eyes of Rasulullah and Shafa'a of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the ones who will leave everything and they want for the sake of shaitan to fill their time. So be careful. Don't think as days are passing and nothing happening. No one when the angerness of Allah Almighty will descend, then 1 minute Allah Almighty destroy all this world and doesn't care. Less than a minute Allah will destroy everything. As He create by B everything, Allah also will finish everything by B. Be careful. Things descending, making all awliya Allah to be very surprised from what is going on. And for this, all of them, they are not translating what is descending. Because they are and ones who full with mercy that asking Allah Almighty to take off all these kinds of arrows of punishment. And these arrows of punishment, Allah Almighty first attacking whom? The giant of jinn, whom they want to make problem in time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah hung them between the earth and the heaven, in a station in between earth and heavens. They were big number, huge number, and Allah kept them first in there, not allow them to go anywhere. So, all of them. Maulana, he said in these times, Allah Azza wa Jal, the one to complete before he left the house, before you go to anywhere, complete 700 times, Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayhi, with three shahada. 700 times, Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayhi, Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayhi. Don't say long, it take time, you cannot, you are busy. How much you are busy, how you have things to do, because if you, Mawlana say the one left it and he goes in hurry, then the what is going to come off of your head, it will be then much worse than you delay yourself a little bit to finish 700 Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh. The one Mawlana say, who will say 700 times, Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh, Allah will create from his breathing when he says, Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh, two malaika, special malaika, and Allah will appoint them to continue the day of Yom HaKiyamah, Astaghfirullah, saying Astaghfirullah Azimah Tubuleh, and to be written for him in his book. And also they will be, by the order of Allah Almighty, protecting him in this 24 hour, nothing to harm him. And all his work and all his business and all whatever he is behind it, Allah will fulfill it and will make it so easy, and it will be successful, everything with this one who will not go out of the house without 700 times Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu. How much it take time? 5 minutes. If you spend the 5 minutes with Allah Almighty, it's not much more better than you to spend than if you don't damn days and days in the hospitals or in the graveyard, in cemetery, or suffering members of your family. And why? Because you missed to say 700 times Astaghfirullah Azim wa Atubu. If you are not able to do them, also there is permission from Ganshe to say 3 times Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, and 300 times Astaghfirullah, 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 and then present them to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all awliya Allah, Amashayhin, Utayhan, Naqshbandiyat, Ali, Ashaab, Nabi, Wali, Wasab, when Sayyidina Shah al-Naqshband, because Sayyidina Shah al-Naqshband, then he will take this and he will continue practicing Astaghfirullah and raise it to the divine presence of Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam by his witnessing that you repent to Allah Almighty that day, and you are a obedient servant to Allah Almighty. Allah will be happy from you. But it's not from us. It is only the interference of Sayyidina Shah al-Naqshband radiallahu anhu, because he is the prince for all the malaika whom they are on the our shoulders, which means whom they are always with us, writing everything, whatever we do, with the intention of it. Not only whatever you do, but also they will look what intention, with what kind of intention you are making what you do, for the sake of Allah Almighty, or for the sake to be said that you are a good one, or by your intention is badly, and or you are committing sins very badly, then also Sayyidina Shah al-Naqshband will be interfering, and he will be the one responsible to adjust you in the divine presence of Allah Almighty, to be always under the eyes of Allah Almighty, under the eyes of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But what he need to say Astaghfirullah. If you don't say Astaghfirullah 300 times with the Shahada, he will not interfere. Then he will leave you until you will be punished by Allah Almighty. And then he will tell you what I will. If you don't know the benefit, what benefiting you, what we can awliya do for you. Awliya can help you when you want to benefit yourself, when you want to make yourself a good way, they will be supporting you to be in the good way. And they will guide you and they will help you to be in the good way. But if you don't want, what do you do? Nothing. And now Shaitan is so clever, making now the murids of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim Qaddasallahu Sirruh, not murids of Grand Shaykh, because why I'm saying not murids of Grand Shaykh? Because the murid of a Grand Shaykh, 99.99%, they are in the graves. No more, anyone remain. The last to remain is Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, and he passed away. Now there is me, my brother, one, two others. And all, we are at the end. And so the murid of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, Qaddasallahu Sirruh, Mawlana now, said that Allah Almighty also punishing them by how punishing them, making instead to practice the teaching of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim. For example, Mawlana Sheikh Nazim 40 years between us, some follow him 30 years, some 20 years, some 25 years, some 10 years, but they follow. And so everyone has plenty of teaching from Mawlana. Instead to be busy by practicing this teaching now, what the shaitan doing? Making them to be busy, Nazimiya, Naqshbandiya, Aliya. Nazimiya, Naqshbandiya, Aliya. If it is the Naqshbandiya, Aliya, or Nazimiya, or Rayhaniya, or Shaitaniya, or anything, who cares? The most important to practice the teaching of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim. Don't follow these ones whom represent shaitan to make you busy by names and not to be busy by the jawhar, by the jewel of the Naqshbandi ways, by the training of the Naqshbandi way, by the training and the practicing of the teaching of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim. The teaching of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, if you do by one sentence or a paragraph, a suhba, one suhba, from thousands of suhba he gave, one paragraph, enough for you to lead you to be a divinely one related to Allah Almighty, if you do by it. How about if you practice all his suhbas as much as you can and to at least be obeying his will and his teaching, how you think Allah will be rewarding you, and how Rasulullah rewarding you, and how awliya will help you. And for example, if we worship from now till the day of judgment, never we will be reaching anything, because Allah Almighty is not so interested in our worshiping. But Allah Almighty, He likes the intention of the one, the niyyah of the one. If He saw that your niyyah is good and you are doing everything, this practicing of the teaching of Mawlana for as love to Allah Almighty, love to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, love to awliya, and whatever you are doing, even though you are seeing yourself as if you are doing nothing but except waiting only the mercies of Allah Almighty, Allah will be very happy, and then He appoints the awliya instead of you on your behalf to finish for you all whatever you have promised Allah Almighty in the day of promises and covenant before we come to this life, and to be written that you are a one whom fulfilling all the will of Allah Almighty and pleasing Allah Almighty and pleasing Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And then all these awliya, they will upgrade you and ascend you to be under the shafa'ah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And for this Allah Almighty, what He said, Allah Almighty said, nothing better please me as the one who approached to me by the obligatories. Because obligatory is obligatory. If you don't do them, you are going to do them on the cover of Jahannam. No one to interfere. Even Rasulullah will not interfere. And Allah Almighty saying, the most to please me, one you will do by my obligatories, approach to me by the obligatories, and still my servant approaching to me by nawafil, by the recommended, by nawafil, which means by the practicing the teaching of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the teaching of Sahaba. You don't know the teaching of Rasulullah, or any one of you know, or us know the teaching of Rasulullah, but no one knows. Anyone knows the teaching of Sa'an? No one knows. But we know the teaching of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, Qaddas Allah Sur, and teaching of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, they are reflecting the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and teaching of Sahaba, because these branches, these awliya, they are one after the other inheriting from the other what he inherited from his sheikh, and this grand sheikh inheriting from the other grand sheikh until they reach to Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu, Sayyidina Ali radiallahu, whom they inherit the practicing of Rasulullah and the teaching of Rasulullah. And so by this, you will be fulfilling the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by practicing the teaching of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim. When you do by this teaching, then Allah Almighty will not look at what you are doing, but He will order Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to appoint awliyaullah, whom if they say, "Oh Allah Almighty," only if they wish anything from Allah Almighty, Allah will give them. As in the hadith, لِلَّهِ رِجَالٌ إِذَا أَرَادُ أَرَادُ. If they wish something, Allah will give them whatever they wish. Even Allah Almighty is not programming this, but if they wish something from Allah Almighty, Allah will program it to be according to what they like, and He give. And for this, Allah Almighty saying, for these ones whom practicing the teaching of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, or the one whom following awliyaullah, there is 124,000 awliya. The one whom following the teaching of 124,000 awliya, but all the 124,000 awliya, they are as if in one hand, and Mawlana Shaykh Nazim in the other hand. Because the one who represents Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he will be as was Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu in between the Sahaba of Rasulullah. All Sahaba used to be for Rasulullah in one hand, and Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq is another in one hand. Like this, yani as if all Sahaba, one eye of Rasulullah, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq is the other eye of Rasulullah. And for this, the teaching of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, so high, advanced, progressing for the one to quickly reach to Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because Allah will order then Rasulullah to appoint awliya to fulfill for you, because only you make intention and try to practice this teaching instead to be involving in this fitna which now is going on between the Muris of the Naqshbandi way, and it is only coming from whom? From the ones whom they are familiar with, Mawlana Shaykh Nazim. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah al-ali al-azim. And like this, Allah Almighty saying, nothing makes me pleased as the one who will be approaching to me by the obligatories, and still my servant approaching to me by nawafil, by recommended, by the sunnah of Rasulullah, by practicing the teaching of Rasulullah. And what is the teaching? How to practice the teaching of Rasulullah? By practicing the teaching of whom represent Rasulullah and tell you what use Rasulullah to do. And for us is Mawlana Shaykh Nazim Qaddas Allah. When you fulfill this teaching, you do by them, and Allah will appoint for you awliya, what Allah is saying, still my servant approaching to me by the recommended, I will love him. Then you will be upgraded, ascend to a station where there is the level where Allah Almighty sending in it all the oceans of love of Allah Almighty to swallow everyone reaching to that level of making Allah Almighty to be pleased. He say, until I will love you. If I love you, I will dress you from my eyes to your eyes, from my ears to your ears, from my tongue to your tongue. Which means Allah Almighty saying, I will dress you by my divinely attributes, godly attributes. I will make you a godly one. If you say to something, be it will be. Oh, my servant, obey me. Yani obey by practicing the teaching of my beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who is the one who obey Allah Almighty? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And who is the one disobeyed Allah Almighty? Shaitan. If you try to practice the teaching of Rasulullah, mean you are addressed by the highest maqam in between creations, whom is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if you never practicing this teaching of Rasulullah, and you are only following the practicing and the desires and what the shaitan decorate for you, and you are happy with it, and then you will be practicing the teaching of shaitan of disobeying Allah Almighty. And Allah Almighty is saying the one who will be approaching to me by the nawafil, I will love him. If I love him, I will dress him from my eyes, from my ears, from my tongue, from my hand. I will make him a divine, the godly one. If he say to something be, it will be. And for this Allah Almighty, what's saying in the Holy Quran? Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullah wa kunu ma'a as-sadiqin. O Mu'mins, be aware from Allah Almighty and be always practicing the teaching of a sadiq, which means always be with a sadiq and practicing what he will tell you to practice, because all this practicing, they are the practicing of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the sahaba of Rasulullah, whom Rasulullah say, I make my sahaba to be like stars. They are stars. By anyone you guide yourself, you will be well guided, reaching to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, reaching to Allah Almighty. How to find sahaba nowadays? You can find spiritual sahaba. Spiritual sahaba, they are these ones whom they are the successors of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu and Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu. They and the successors of sahaba, till nowadays they are 124,000 between the ummah, not only one, but they are 124,000. If you are able to follow one of them, you will be reaching to love of Allah Almighty, and then you will be dressed by divinely attributes of Allah Almighty, divinely names of Allah Almighty, until Allah will make you to present His greatest name. And you will be then like a secret walking on this earth. Secret of Allah Almighty, secret of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not by only that you are practicing, but you show good intention and love to Allah Almighty by trying to practice. Allah will appoint awliyaullah, appoint malaika for you to continue this practicing for you until you will reach to the love of Allah Almighty, and Allah will appoint you to be a secret, divinely godly secret of Him on this earth between children of Adam alayhi salam. And this one then will be a one whom, like a magnetic field, how if there is a magnetic iron bars, you will see all the needles and all these pins quickly, or nails will come and attract it to them. Like this, you will be a magnetic field of light, where all the lights, whom represented by children of Adam alayhi salam, will be gathering over you, so that you will be a one ascending them, upgrading them to the divine presence of Allah Almighty. What you need only to show good intention and to avoid to enter into any fitna, in any thing which make the heart to be disturbance of the heart, not to disturb your heart by whatever fitna is going on. What we need? Obey. What Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, for example, his will, finish, obey, and don't care. there is not other than you, Maulana, to go and make sujood to anyone. No. He say, I am appointing this one only, except. It's not like this. He say anything else. Don't refuse. When Allah Almighty ordering the malaika to make sujood to Adam, only to obey, to make sujood. They obey. The one who refused, what happened to him? He was then cursed by Allah Almighty and was to be totally bankrupt and kicked out of the mercies of Allah Almighty. Let us not be ones like this, but to obey the will of Allah, of Mawlana, then we are obeying the will of Rasulullah. By obeying the will of Rasulullah, we are obeying the will of Allah Almighty. Then Allah Almighty will deal with us as He was blessing the malaika whom they obey the will of Allah Almighty. And as much as you can in this time, which now we enter just this morning from midnight, entering into it, a very difficult time in front of us, and every day is going to be increase and increase and increase and increase, that all the awliya, their back was broken this night by this burden and these arrows which was descending over mankind, over all creations from heavens, and these are going to appear not in one day or today, but in the several months and years in front of us, until the order of Allah Almighty for finishing the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be over. And for this, Mawlana say, nothing will save you except astaghfirullah al-azim wa atubu ilayh. Astaghfirullah al-azim wa atubu ilayh. To be busy yourself at least by 700 times, astaghfirullah al-azim wa atubu ilayh. Even less, 300 times with shahada, astaghfirullah al-azim wa atubu ilayh also can be. And to practice what Mawlana Sheikh Nazim 40 years teaching us, or 30 years, or 20 years, or how much you follow him, what you learn from him, practice it. Don't go to books of people whom they put as they like, or according to their style. They said this, Mawlana said. No, Mawlana didn't say. Practice what you heard from Mawlana. This practice. That is what you heard from Mawlana, and every one of you, at least, he heard one hadith. As the Sahaba, is any one of the Sahaba didn't memorize from Rasulullah and heard one hadith? Not all the hadith. One hadith. And by one hadith, if they do by it, they reach to the highest level of to be pleasing Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you memorize one ayah of the Holy Quran and you by it, if you do by it, you will be reaching as if you do by the whole Quran. If you do by one hadith, as if you did by all the hadith of Rasulullah. If you do by one teaching you heard from Mawlana. Don't take from this or that. What you heard from Mawlana, do by it, then you will be reaching to love of Allah Almighty, and you will be dressed by a divinely godly body, and Allah will change your elements from human elements to be divinely elements related to heavens, and you will be supported by heavenly wings to fly in the kingdom of Allah Almighty and to be awliyaullah. But the one who want to be busy by the fitna going on, and by these names, and by what this is saying and that saying, and like this, he is going to be a loser, and he will not reach to anything. What is the important for us is to obey and to accept the will and do according what you learned from Maulana Sheikh Nasr. What you heard from Maulana, do by it. Don't open books to see, because everyone writing in the books according what he likes. And he will say this, Maulana say. Maulana, once he say like this, anytime Maulana say to Rasulullah said, always the sign of a mu'min and a good end, that when you see a one passing away and making the finger of witness up, don't cover it. And the brought for us teaching to cover it now. Which teaching we follow? Teaching of Allah Almighty, Rasulullah and Maulana by raising up the witness finger or to close it. And then they told you this is Allah, name of Allah Almighty. Name of Allah Almighty, this hand, where you put it when you want to clean yourself, you put the name of Allah Almighty in your place of cleaning of waste. Is this what Allah Almighty ordering? And so be careful not to follow these teachings or these books or these people whom they want to make from the sincere murids of Maulana Sheikh Nazim a bad ones and to make them to miss the way. Follow what you heard from Maulana Sheikh Nazim. Direct. Every one of you heard something from Maulana. What you heard, follow it. And do by it. And all of you, you heard Maulana saying to keep saying Astaghfirullah, to repent to Allah Almighty, and to do at least 700 times Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh. And also there is plenty which Maulana said to everyone to do. What Maulana, for example, gave you to do, do by it all this practicing. And obey Maulana by his will that his son is his successor. What you have. And then you will be a one pleasing Allah Almighty and the chosen one to Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and awliya, and you will be supported by awliya Allah, especially by Sultan of awliya Mawlana Shaykh Nazim. The one who supported by Sultan of awliya Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, as I am informed this to me, you didn't hear it, but this, I heard it, something which I practice it and heard it because, and I am practicing it, is supported and well sponsored by seed of awliya Grand Sheikh Maulana Sheikh Abdullah Dawastani, Qaddas Allah. And the one who will not follow the teaching of Maulana Sheikh Nazim, even Grand Sheikh will not look after him or support him or sponsor him. And for this now, is a time which is a very difficult time coming in front of all the murids of Maulana Sheikh Nazim all over the world and all the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nothing will be saving you except the practicing the teaching which you heard it, not to find it in books, but what you heard from Maulana Sheikh Nazim to do by it, and especially to keep 700 times Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh. If you are not able, at least 300. And we are doing it already, because every prayer we are doing between the Sunnah and the Iqama, three Shahada and 100 times Astaghfirullah, is not? And so if you see at the end of the day, you find you do 500 times Astaghfirullah. But plenty of people, they don't care, even they pray without praying the Sunnah, they enter directly with the Jama'ah, or they make call Iqama and enter without saying three Shahada and 100 times Astaghfirullah, or recite three times Ikhlas al-Sharif, and this is very bad, make them to be under the blaming, to be blamed by the one who represent the divine will of Allah Almighty in between His creation. So be careful. Don't see me this night, now this morning I am a little bit changing, because what was descending all this night make me not to be in my usual mood, totally different. For this I am so under a burden, not for myself only, but for what is going to come over the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Mu'izz of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim Qaddus Allah Sirruhu and all the Mu'izz of all awliya of the fitna and all these misunderstanding, and how they are going to follow things which make shaitan happy and will be disobeying Allah Almighty and unpleasing Allah Almighty and pleasing shaitan. What please Allah Almighty? Humbleness. What please Allah Almighty? Take off all hatred, enmity from your heart. What please Allah Almighty? To be good with everyone. What please Allah Almighty? Is always to see yourself a guilty one, and you need to be always in need of the forgiveness of Allah Almighty. And to see yourself like this, you must as much as you can to be well practicing Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu. Allah doesn't like anyone to cheat the other. Don't cheat each other. Don't cheat your the ones whom they are in brotherhood to you or sisterhood to you, whom they are murids of or following Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, by cheating them in things which never Mawlana said it or accept it, and you will say this Mawlana saying so, only to cheat them. What for? To collect money from them. All what they are doing only to be making themselves rich in this life, but they are going to be very poor in the grave and passing away from this life and in the other life. Look at the graveyard. Anyone taking anything with him? All the left empty-handed. All of them, nothing taking with them. What you will take with you? You will take with you only the love of Allah Almighty, the love of Rasulullah, the shafa'ah of Rasulullah, and the forgiveness of Allah Almighty. This is what you say. And they say you will take your good deeds. Don't think you have a good deeds. No one has a good deeds. Anyone who is dressed by an ego and by a satanic world and by desires and shahwa, sexual desires, has good deeds. Once Grand Sheikh told me, the one who go every day to visit the WC, the toilet, and to put his waste in it, he is an awliya. Awliya, they visit toilets. They have waste to put on toilet. You think? No, they don't have. And for this, be careful. Since you enter the toilet, mean you are nothing. You must make yourself to be a one whom Allah Almighty dressing you from His attributes, from His names. When you will be divinely one, then you will recognize yourself. And Allah Almighty is saying in the hadith also, I send everyone to this planet, to this life, to know himself, so that he knows me. Man arifa nafsahu, faqad arifa rabbah, the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The one who knows himself, he knows Allah Almighty. He knows his God. But the one who forget himself, the one who lose himself, is going to gain Allah Almighty or to know Allah Almighty? Never. And you will see now all people, how they are busy only in making their life to be only so prosperous, and no one paying any attention for the Akhirah or for the way of Allah Almighty, or to be good with Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and awliya, and to be humble. And Allah Almighty saying, how much you will be humble to me, how much I will upgrade you. How to be humble to Allah Almighty? Anyone seeing Allah Almighty? Anyone reaching to Allah Almighty in this life? No. You will see Allah Almighty in this, the other life. How to be humble to Allah Almighty in this life? And Mawlana, from his teaching to us, one, you will be humble to whom Allah created, to the creation of Allah Almighty, to all the creation, animals, plants, children of Adam alayhi salam, to everything Allah created it. One, you will be showing all kind of humbleness and respect to them. This goes to Allah Almighty. And Allah Almighty saying, I am the richest, I am not in need for your worshipping. What coming to me from you is serving me. Serve me, my servant. How to serve Allah Almighty? Allah Almighty telling Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, what you did for me, Ya Musa, Mawlana, was teaching, this teaching of Mawlana Shaykh Nazr and Ranji, what you did for me? He said, I am praying for you, I am fasting for you, I am spreading your message, bringing people to be believers. And this all benefit coming to you. You are getting the reward from me for them. But by what you serve me, as Allah Almighty, by what you serve me, Sayyidina Musa was served, by what you serve us, what you can serve, anyone can serve Allah Almighty. Because Sayyidina Musa used to talk with Allah Almighty, the one who has no revelation, he has no wisdom. So his, from the side of wisdom was not given to Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. And so he didn't know what to answer Allah Almighty. Allah Almighty teaching him, when you serve my people, Ya Musa, you are serving me. Serving people, serving my creation, you are serving me. And like this, there's a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that a whore, once they kicked her out of the country, and she was doesn't know where to go in this desert outside of her country, until she was so thirsty, but Allah make her to find a well of water. So she brought her shoes and she was drinking water from the well. All at a sudden, Allah sending a dog. And this dog jumping, want to reach to the water to drink, but was not able. Like, because mankind, one of us, is a little bit taller, can reach to take water. But the animal, he has no hand, nothing, how to reach to the water. He cannot. If he want to jump, he will fall down in the well. And so what she did, she brought her shoes, she put water in it, and she gave the dog. Until the dog was totally, he was so thirsty, until he was very satisfied, no more thirsty and well, then he looked at heavens and was praying for this whore. And Allah Almighty sending to Rasulullah, for the sake of what she did to these animals, I forgived her and I dressed her by light of wilaya from me to be awliya to me, my beloved Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. See, for serving a dog, how Allah Almighty deal with the one and was pleased. How about if you serve mankind? How Allah Almighty will be happy from the one of you. You have brothers and sisters in humanity whom they are not finding one piece of rice to eat, no dress, nothing, under snow, and no one helping them, no one thinking about them. And instead of to be all united, the fitna between us now by what to name the Naqshbandi way. Name it as anything you want to name it. Okay. The most important to do by the teaching of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, not by names. We are not worshipping names. We are not worshipping people. We are not worshipping shuyukh. Our shuyukh, they are like imam for us. When we stand to pray, we appoint one to conduct the prayer, to be imam. Is not? And this one we pray behind him. But we are praying to whom? Or worshipping whom? This imam or Allah Almighty? We are worshipping Allah Almighty. We are praying for Allah Almighty. But Rasulullah, he say, you must appoint an imam for you. And Allah Almighty appointing for all his creation, for all children of Adam alayhi salam, for all malaika, for all jinn, for all creation. What an imam, what Allah saying, وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ أَحْصَيْنَاهُ فِي إِمَامٍ مُبِينٍ. Is not every day we recite it in Surah Yasin al-Sharif, the first ayat of Yasin, what Allah saying, وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ أَحْصَيْنَاهُ فِي إِمَامٍ مُبِينٍ. There is an imam to Allah Almighty. Allah appointed for his creation. Who is this imam appointed to the creation of Allah Almighty? From pre-eternal forever, Allah Almighty appearing, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. He is the imam. But Allah Almighty telling you to worship Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or to worship Allah Almighty? Answer.
Allah
Almighty. But to take Rasulullah, what? Imam for you, to guide you, to be the Rasul of you, to Allah Almighty. Without Rasulullah, you cannot reach to the divine presence of Allah Almighty. And the same, without an imam, never a jama'ah can their prayer be accepted. If Allah accepting the prayer of the imam, all the jama'ah are accepted. If Allah is not accepting the prayer of the imam, all the jama'ah behind him not accepted. And for this Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the hadith, choose whom to appoint imam for you. And for this Rasulullah didn't appoint any imam for the Sahaba when he got sick and passing away, except Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, the one who can be accepted by Allah Almighty and Rasulullah, so that all of them they will be accepted. And the same, our shuyukh, Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, Grand Shaykh, they are our imams, our guidance to Allah Almighty and to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not to worship them, but to do by what they taught us, by to practice their teaching. And everyone, no one is practicing their teaching, only we are decorating ourselves by their knowledge and what coming from them. And we are so involved in the fitna that in every country, every city, every place, all of them, they are splitted into two or three parties against each other, killing each other, fighting each other. For what? What for? What for? The chair? Who will sit on the chair? We are not politicians. We are dervish. We are searching to please Allah Almighty. And Allah saying, to please me, practice the teaching of my beloved Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
وما زال still my servant approaching to me by nawafil, by the practicing of beloved Muhammad, by sunnah of Rasulullah. Nawafil means sunnah of Rasulullah. I love him. And if I love him, I will dress him from our eyes to his eyes like this, which means he will dress us from his attributes. And how to reach to the teaching of Rasulullah? Through books, you can reach? Never. You reach by the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by following his successors, because this successor was a successor of before him a successor, a Siddiq. From one Siddiq to Siddiq, to Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, or to Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu, whom they were following in minute by minute, second by second, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And through these Siddiqs, they are bringing to us the practicing of Rasulullah to practice. And if you practice this teaching, then you will be reaching to be a one representing the love of Allah Almighty, to be dressed to you, and then to be dressed by the attributes of Allah Almighty. And don't take from anyone. Every one of you sit with Mawlana Sheikh Nasr, even once in your life, is not? What you heard from him, do by it, enough for you. Even one sahbah from him to you is enough for you. No need for many sahbah. What you heard from him, do by it. Enough for you to lead you to be under the love of Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and awliyaullah. And then you will be dressed by the attributes of Allah Almighty, by the attributes of Rasulullah, and you will be dressed by a secret from Mawlana, and you will be then a divinely godly one, as Allah Almighty saying in the Holy Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kunu rabbaniyin. And don't involve in any fitna, whatever kind of fitna, don't involve yourself in it. Always say, I am obeying the will of Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, the will of Granche, the will of Awliyaullah, what Mawlana, his will, I am obeying. I am following the will of Mawlana. May Allah forgive us and mercy us and take off all these burdens and make no any of these arrows of punishment descending over mankind to be hitting us, but Allah to take it off from us and from all our families and from all the nation of Rasulullah. Let it go to oceans, to seas, not to go over people and over the children of Adam alayhi salam. Allah forgive us and mercy us, and as much as you can, keep saying Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh. Keep istighfar of Allah Almighty. Even you enter into any mistake, because Rasulullah said, all of you, you are sinners, and the best of the sinners is the one who repent to Allah Almighty. يعني كلكم خطاؤون وأفضل الخطاؤون التوابون. All of you commit خطيئة, sins, but the best of you whom repent quickly to Allah Almighty, so that Allah will not punish him. And then Rasulullah makes shafa for him, and the awliya will find a way to upgrade him to be under the love of Allah Almighty and the mercies of Allah Almighty. May Allah forgive us and mercy us. إلى شرف النبي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وآله وصحبه حضرة أستاذنا وأستاذ أستاذ سدي وإلى موالينا الكرام خاصة سيدنا شيخ عثمان ولي الله لله تعالى الفاتح. Don't say well away, Shaykh Muhammad. He will kill you, Allah. As-salamu alaykum. You understand? Or you are sleeping? You listen to what I said, or no one listen? You listen? Or you were sleeping, saying, Yallah, when he will finish, Yallah. You are busy.
So many people that I'm doing.